You may ask, what if the protection domain is so large that it needs all of the hardware address space? Maybe the file system code base is so big that it needs the entire hardware address space. Cannot share it with anybody else. Similarly, the code base for the storage module is so big that it may occupy the entire hardware address space. Now, this way the situation, that is, if the protection domains are so large that they pretty much occupy the entire hardware address space, and if the TLB does not support address space tagging, then you have to do a TLB flush on a context switch. If you go from this service to this service, you need to do a TLB flush because the memory footprint of each of these services is as big as the hardware address space that's available on the processor. Or in other words, the segments overlap, and therefore you have to do a TLB flush when you do a context switch. The cost that we've been talking about so far is the explicit cost. That is, the cost that is incurred for flushing the TLB at the point of a context switch. And for small protection domains that we want to go across, we want to avoid that cost, and we can do that by packing them in the linear address space provided by the hardware. But if the memory footprint of the service is so big that it occupies the hardware address space of the architecture completely, the explicit cost we're going to incur, because we have to do a TLB flush if the TLB is not address space tagged, but that explicit cost is very insignificant compared to the implicit cost that is going to be incurred. Now, what do we mean by implicit cost? We mean cache effects, that is, the loss of locality going from this service to this service, that the cache is not going to have the working set of this service when we go from here to here. That impact is much more than the explicit cost. For example, LeetK shows that on the specific architecture in which they implemented L3, which is a Pentium architecture, it had 32 entries for kernel translations and 64 entries for user translations. Even if you want to flush the entire TLB, all the entries in the TLB, it takes 864 cycles to do that. But the loss of locality when a service goes from this to this, in terms of cache effects, is going to be much more significant, because with a large address space, you expect that you're doing more work in the subsystem, and the implicit costs are going to dominate.